Welcome to Latin Nation, celebrating your generation from coast to coast. I'm your host, Umberto Guida. And I'm very excited to be kicking off today's show with an actor who's been gracing the big and small screen for several decades now. Isa Morales definitely exudes an energy that few performers wield. Behind the scenes, he puts that energy to use as one of Hollywood's leading activists. On screen, he gives any scene he's in a dose of intensity. And now he takes his talent to the acclaimed series, Magic City, a star show in its second season that takes place in the swinging Miami Beach of 50 years ago, when mobsters and Cuban revolutionaries littered its beaches with sometimes a little more action than the young city could handle. Check this out.
Brought to you by State Farm. For auto, home, life, and banking, get to a better state. Isai Morales takes plenty of pride in portraying characters of depth and substance. And the veteran actor makes sure that when given a chance to play a role that can make Latino audiences proud, he puts everything he has into it, like he's doing this season on Magic City.
Well, it's fascinating because there's only so much I can say right now. Now, I thought, okay, he's gonna come back and mount a campaign to retake the island. This is my character, El Tiburón, the shark.
No.
El Tiburón.
Shark. One thing about sharks, they swim in murky waters. They feed best at night, you know? They come up from below, they surprise you. And I think that's as much as I can say about my character, who may or may not, you know, be all that, you know, we see of him.
Victor Lázaro. Maria Lázaro was your wife?
Yes.
Maria Lázaro, que murió en la Bahía de Matanza.
Sí.
I was there.
What fascinated me about El Tiburón was the fact, his name, right away, El Tiburón. Okay, why is this guy called El Tiburón? Number two, he's coming into possibly the most divisive time, you know, in Miami's history for of a Latino.
We were all strangers. Nobody spoke. Waiting in the dark for the boat, you know.
He was a pilot in Batista's army. Air Force. He became a general. He defected from Batista. He saw where the winds of change were going, and he liked the concept, the idea of freedom from corruption, of equality for all that that Castro represented in the beginning. He saw the hubris. He saw that revolutions start with the best of intentions. And he became disillusioned. So he's now going back to do things the right way. Specifically from Cubans. As a matter of fact, it's kind of been quiet in that department. That's okay. What I did have to have on the set was our Cuban crew, okay? There's a couple of guys that I would look, and when they'd be like that, I'm like, eso fue. You know what I mean? Oye, caballo, te la comiste. What you may not know is that a guy named Mitch Glazer, the creator of the show, is half Cubano. How's that?
She, my friend, spoke your name three times.
You know, we are, if not the largest segment of movie-going public that sees more movies than its numbers reflect. In other words, we're overrepresented in the ticket-buying and television-watching demographics. Overrepresented, but underrepresented when it comes to the stories and who matters. So here we are consuming someone else's, you know, culture, and that's fine to a degree, but it's time now. It's time that we say, hey, we don't just pay taxes in this country. We don't just, you know, use up, our immigrants don't just use up resources. We really contribute to the fabric of this great nation, and we are part of it.
Buenas noches, señor. Antonio, Victor. Si le puedo ayudar con algo, ¿me puedo servir? Por favor, me llama. El teléfono en la casa está atrás. Ten buen día. Gracias.